Tutorial on Easy Splice. Place the Easy Splice strand between the two ends of the belt to be joined, matching and aligning the space of the strand with the spaces of the belt. Make sure that the cut end of the Easy Splice strand is on the bottom. Once both ends of the belt are aligned with the spaces in the Easy Splice strand, hook the end loops in as shown and rotate the strand 180 degrees. The proper method of hooking and rotating the strand is shown in this close-up view. Once you have your strand hooked in the end loops and in the proper position following the rotation step, snap the second space of the Easy Splice strand through the second space of the belt that you're splicing. Then repeat this step in every space, moving from right to left until the edge of the belt is reached. You now have the bottom half of the belt joined completely. Once the bottom half is locked into the appropriate spaces across the width of the belt, turn your strand about 1/4 turn on a 90 degree upward, as shown in this close-up, so that the top half of the clips are exposed and are ready to link with the other side of the belt. Now take the other side of your belt and hook the first space over and through the Easy Splice strand as shown. Working from left to right until you reach the edge of the belt. Your Easy Splice strand is now in position to complete the belt joint. You can retension your conveyor belt circuit and move to the next step to lock your splice strand into place, making the joint permanent and safe. This is where our Easy Splice profiling pliers come in. This tool is designed exclusively for this purpose and will help lock your Easy Splice strand in place to the exact specified crimp depth, and will not damage your conveyor belt or your newly made splice joint like conventional pliers would. The Easy Splice profiling pliers come with a full set of jaw bits and are designed to fit the various wire diameters in the wire belt line. You must choose the appropriate bit and insert it, beveled edge first, into the pliers before you begin the crimp locking process. The profiling pliers are also designed with grooves in the lower jaw that correspond to the belt joint Z-bends. Now, you need to orient the grooves in the pliers with the Z-bend joints in the belt strand. Once everything is aligned, you can start the locking process in the center of the belt, or nearer to one side. Do not lock the joints on either edge of the belt until all of the joints are already crimped. Once you begin locking your strand into place, move from right to left, making sure that each joint is crimped tightly. You'll know that they're locked in place because you'll feel the pliers stop when you squeeze them to the correct depth. Once all of the joints across the width of the belt are locked into place, you can crimp the strand on the two outside edges, as shown in this close-up view. Now your belt is ready to roll with the strongest, safest, longest-lasting splice joint that can be made on this type of conveyor system.